These days, you can get your full genome sequence for less than $200. Now, that's equivalent to about £160, or just as much as you would pay 23andMe for an Ancestry Plus health report. So why, at the end of the day, would anyone pay 23andMe this much money to just get their SNP sequence? That's what we're gonna talk about in this episode and more, so make sure you watch till the end. Now, 23andMe is one of those Silicon Valley juggernauts that has emerged in less than a decade and become one of the largest genetic testing companies in the world. And it provides services to multiple continents, including the Americas and Europe. And 23andMe boasts a user base of 10 million right now, and it's growing rapidly. One of the reasons why 23andMe has grown so rapidly and continues to grow is the network effect. The network effect that has resulted from its Ancestry Report feature. 23andMe's Ancestry Report feature allows you to connect with near or even distant relatives who are, for example, your first, second, third cousins, and you can even talk to them on the 23andMe platform. But something to keep in mind is that this feature will only be useful to you if you know that some of your family members might have used 23andMe wherever they're located in the world. In my case, I have noticed that it's only my distant relatives that are located in the USA that have used the 23andMe Ancestry Report feature, and they're the only people that I can actually connect to. As a fact, I do know that a lot of my relatives do live in India and even the UK, but I cannot connect to them because they have not used this feature. If you have all of your ancestry coming out of a South Asian country like India, then 23andMe is not going to tell you where in India your family might have migrated from. Now, I know for a fact that India as a country does comprise of genetically diverse sets of populations, but that's something that you're not going to be able to see in your 23andMe report, unless your family migrated outside of India, let's say from China. And this is something that I really want to stress on for people that are looking at 23andMe to provide them with information regarding where the family has migrated from within India.
I'm from India, guys. 99.6% chance I'm from the India-Pakistan region. And get this. Oh, wow. It's very possible that my ancestors were from this region in the last 200 years. How incredible is that?
Make sure you check out my previous video on 23andMe to see how my results came out as. So let's move on to why you would consider 23andMe over, let's say, any other genetic testing service, or let's say getting your full genome sequence. Now, what 23andMe does offer that is very valuable is that it looks at those short nucleotide polymorphisms, those SNPs, that give us valuable information regarding our likelihood to develop certain diseases or certain traits. And 23andMe is pretty efficient at looking at a few short nucleotide polymorphisms and getting as much data out of your genetic material as possible. And it's only getting better and better. They do frequently update their system with new information. Right now, the latest information provides you with your likelihood of developing type 2 diabetes, for example, or familial hypercholesterolemia. And if that's something what you're looking for, by all means, go ahead and get this service done. But if you're really concerned about certain genetic conditions and your chances of developing it, then I would personally strongly recommend you get a proper genetic test done for that specific purpose. Go to the doctors and explain why you want a certain genetic test done for, let's say, breast cancer. SNPs, although they are reliable to a certain extent, they do not give you the complete information. You're not looking at your full genome or even the full genes that are associated with certain cancers or certain disorders. So that's something you should always keep in mind when you're looking at 23andMe's service. And one more thing that I really want to stress is the fact that 23andMe is basically a data company. It's a company that collects and processes information. So 23andMe uses third-party laboratories to analyze your data. When you spit in a bottle and send that spit, it's actually a third-party laboratory that analyzes your data and sends that SNP information to 23andMe, who is the only company that can identify that sample as belonging to you. And 23andMe does seem to go through a lot of steps to ensure that your privacy or your information isn't leaked. And this is something that's really crucial in a modern day environment. No matter what 23andMe tells you, it's a data company and all data companies can be hacked. If not today, then there will always be a way in the future when it can be hacked. And one more thing that you might not be aware of is that the CEO and co-founder of 23andMe is Anna Wojcicki. And Anna Wojcicki is the wife of Sergey Brin. In terms of the greatest strength of the 23andMe service, I would say it's the list of disorders that you can find out how likely you are to develop today or in the future based on your SNP data. So overall, I would say that the ancestry feature of 23andMe has not been useful at all for me. I'm getting more and more second cousins that are doing 23andMe and who are picked up by the platform, and the platform tells me that it's detected someone who might be a relatively close family member of mine. And the Neanderthal feature, I would say, is completely useless. It didn't give me anything useful for me to know. At the end of the day, it's the disorders and my traits that were quite interesting to find out. Make sure you buy exactly the right package for the services that you're looking for from 23andMe. And that's it from my side. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure you also check out my previous episode if you haven't done that, and I'll see you next time.